The Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra could be the first phone to come with a new privacy-protecting function that uses AI to block anyone snooping on your screen. According to Jukanostreve industry sources, who cited that, Samsung Electronics is expected to apply the Flex Magic Pixel technology for the first time in the upcoming Galaxy S26 Ultra, scheduled for release next year. The feature implements a privacy protection film effect to enhance user privacy, drawing attention to whether it will later expand to foldable products. According to industry sources on the 18th, Samsung plans to equip the Galaxy S26 Ultra with Samsung Display's next-generation display, Flex Magic Pixel. The Galaxy S26 series will be reorganized from the existing Standard, Plus, and Ultra models into Pro, Air, and Ultra, with Flex Magic Pixel applied only to the top-tier Ultra model. An industry insider said, Flex Magic Pixel will be applied to the Ultra among the Galaxy S26 series. Samsung Display has been developing this technology for quite some time, but this is the first time it is entering full-scale mass production. Adding, there is a high possibility that the next Fold and Flip series will also adopt Flex Magic Pixel. Flex Magic Pixel is a next-generation display technology first introduced by Samsung Display at the 2024 Mobile World Congress. It uses AI to control OLED pixels and adjust specific viewing angles. For example, when a user opens an application that might expose personal information, AI precisely adjusts the pixels to create an effect similar to attaching a privacy protection film on the smartphone screen. The technology was also showcased at K Display 2025 this year. With Flex Magic Pixel, users can protect their privacy without attaching an additional film. Typically, privacy protection films reduce image quality or brightness, but this technology addresses those drawbacks while simultaneously delivering top-level image quality. He also cited that, an industry source explained, it is a technology that adjusts viewing angles by controlling the OLED pixels themselves, adding, users can experience both privacy protection and the highest image quality. Another technology expected to create synergy with Flex Magic Pixel is color filter on encapsulation. According to industry reports, the Galaxy S26 Ultra will be the first bar-type smartphone to adopt color filter on encapsulation technology. Color filter on encapsulation technology replaces the polarizer in OLED with a color filter, printing it on top of the thin film encapsulation and replacing the conventional pixel-defined layer with black pixel-defined layer. Samsung Display brands this technology as LED. A polarizer is a thin film that allows light to pass in only one direction, preventing external light from reflecting off electrodes between pixels. This helps display pure blacks and ensures outdoor visibility. The core of color filter on encapsulation technology is removing the polarizer and instead inserting a color filter. Removing the polarizer makes the panel thinner and increases light transmittance, reducing power consumption, while the added color filter improves color reproduction. Internal light reflections are blocked by black pixel-defined layer, which is produced by replacing the base material of pixel-defined layer photosensitive polyamide with a black-based material. Since the Galaxy Z Fold 3 in 2021, Samsung Display has applied color filter on encapsulation technology to the Fold series. For the Flip lineup, it was introduced for the first time in the Galaxy Z Flip 7 released this year. The industry expects wider adoption in bar-type smartphones, as the technology makes panels thinner and reduces power consumption. Industry experts also emphasize that color filter on encapsulation technology is essential for applying Flex Magic Pixel. Color filter on encapsulation offsets the light loss that can occur when Flex Magic Pixel is activated. One industry official stated, with color filter on encapsulation applied and the polarizer removed, it becomes possible to implement Flex Magic Pixel. We expect color filter on encapsulation to be widely applied in next generation displays such as Flex Magic Pixel and sensor embedded displays due to its high light transmittance. The upshot would be something a bit like the privacy protecting screen protectors you can now attach to phones, which keep the content of your screen hidden from others who aren't seeing it straight on. However, Flex Magic Pixel supposedly wouldn't have the same problems as traditional screen protectors, which can often lower the visual quality or brightness. The upshot would be something a bit like the privacy-protecting screen protectors you can now attach to phones, which keep the content of your screen hidden from others who aren't seeing it straight on. However, Flex Magic Pixel supposedly wouldn't have the same problems as traditional screen protectors, which can often lower the visual quality or brightness. So with Flex Magic Pixel, you may keep important and personal info to yourself without affecting screen quality. This might be particularly handy for somebody who relies on public transport, as otherwise the individuals surrounding you may probably snoop on your screen. But it may be a reassuring feature for anyone. And while we take the claim of this coming to the S26 Ultra with a pinch of salt, this is actually a tech that Samsung has already showed off. So it exists, and it would make sense for Samsung to bring it to a phone. In any event, these insiders indicate that the Galaxy S26 Ultra will be the only member of the Samsung Galaxy S26 line to get Flex Magic Pixel. But they add that it's probable the Galaxy Z Fold 8 and the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 8 will also get it. This would involve removing its OLED screen's polarizer and replacing it with a color filter, a modification that might make the screen thinner while boosting color reproduction and reducing power consumption. Samsung already utilizes this tech in their foldable phones, but so far it hasn't yet been employed in a non-foldable phone. So if the Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra does offer both of these screen enhancements, then it could have some substantial benefits over other cell phones. We'll probably find out for sure whether it features these in January or February, as that's likely when the Samsung Galaxy S26 range will ship. If Samsung adheres to its regular timetable, then we're going to see the Galaxy S26 phones arriving during January 2026, and we've just obtained some leaked information on two of the major specs of the base model in the series. According to well-known source Digital Chat Station, the regular Galaxy S26 is going to arrive up with a 6.27-inch display and a 4,300 mAh battery, both of which represent improvements based on the current model. The Samsung Galaxy S25 boasts a 6.2-inch screen and a 4,000 mAh battery, which are also the same specs we saw in the Galaxy S24 the year before. It's taken a while, but it's wonderful to see some extra battery capacity added to the lowest model at last. Of course, it's hard to say how much difference a raise in battery capacity is going to make to real battery life, given there are other factors involved besides the size of the battery, but it surely can't do any harm. The report was repeated by another established leaker, Taran Vats, who added the S26 Pro name. There's been previous conjecture that the basic Galaxy S26 phone may actually gain the Pro label next year, with recent sources claiming that the Galaxy S25 Plus will be the last of that particular line of phones. We may be looking at the Galaxy S26 Pro, the Galaxy S26 Edge, and the Galaxy S26 Ultra when it comes to flagship phones from Samsung next year. Once again, it's expected to be the Ultra model that gets the most significant changes on top of what the current phones already offer. There's previously been discussion that the most expensive phone in the series may gain camera and charging speed enhancements. No doubt we'll be hearing more about all three phones between now and January 2026, but in the meantime we've got the Google Pixel 10 launch coming up this week, which may set the bar again for the greatest Android phones. In recent years, Samsung has been relatively consistent with the release date of its S series phones, while the phones used to come in spring, as late as May 29, in the case of the Galaxy S3. Starting 2019, the devices have been issued no later than March 6, with launch events conducted in January or February. It's been trending earlier too. The Samsung Galaxy S25 released on February 7, whereas the S24 premiered on January 31. In other words, it's quite likely that the Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra will be on shelves by mid-February, with an event roughly 2 weeks before a release day. The key question is whether Samsung will want to hike the price in 2026. The Galaxy S25 Ultra launched at $1,299, escalating to $1,419 for 512 gig storage, or $1,659 for 1 terabyte, which is the same set of MSRP as its predecessor. The three Ultra handsets before that started at $1,199, so hopefully it's a good omen that things will stay unchanged for another year. Another bright sign It's been rumored that the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 2, expected to power the upcoming phones, won't cost Samsung more than the Gen 1. If true, there's one less added expense that Samsung might pass on to the consumer. It would be immensely surprised if the Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra weren't one of the greatest phones of 2026, but whether it will justify the price of an upgrade to existing flagship owners is less crystal cut. While it sounds like the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 2 and extra RAM will deliver unrivaled performance, other aspects sound more incremental, notably on the photographic side of things. But there's still a long time to go until the phone releases, and a few more exciting tweaks may flip this from one to watch to the most anticipated launch of 2026. So let us know thought in the comment section. Then we'll see you in the next one. See you tomorrow. Peace out.